अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू चैप्टर नंबर 9, दैट इज़ चेंजिंग लाइफ साइकिल। टुडे विल स्टार्ट विद पोस्ट इंडिपेंडेंस पीरियड। कीपिंग इन द माइंड द ग्लोबल एंड द रूरल डेवलपमेंट, द कलेक्टिव डेवलपमेंट स्कीम हैज़ केम इनटू द फोर्स। प्लान्स वर मेड फॉर इम्प्रूविंग फैमिली फार्मिंग टेक्नोलॉजी, इंक्रीजिंग द एरिया ऑफ एग्रीगेटेड लैंड, एक्सटेंडिंग एजुकेशनल फैसिलिटीज, इनएक्टिंग द लॉज for the land reform under the scheme. It was also aimed at increasing agriculture produce as well as expanding the means of transport, health service and scope for education in the rural area. It was decided to give priority to the economic development in the village. The government undertook the work through the medium of the Gram Panchayat, which included the people from the caste and tribes. To achieve this, the Gram Panchayat Samiti and Zilla Parishad were empowered with more authority. Now after the post independence period, we have targeted the village that we need to improve this kind of village to get the proper education facility or different kind of farming technology or expanding of means of transport, health service. This we have to keep focus on because urbanization was keep improving, but what about the rural area? So the Gram Panchayat, which is the basic we can say a judge or court in the village. So the government has given authority to Gram Panchayat and Zila Parishad to make a decision for proper decision for rural areas, which what is needed in the village, what is the thing which is avoiding in the village. So this is important, and it is this authority is given to Gram Panchayat and Zila Parishad. Changing economic life. Earlier, every village was economically self-sufficient. A majority of villages were dependent on farming. Farm produce used to be distributed among the artisans as the payment for their work. Now the situation has changed. Rural areas are engaged in the agriculture and the occupation ancillary to the farming, while urban societies engage in the non-agriculture production and the service sector. Even if the urbanization is changing in their standard of living, the rural area and the area is also changing. Why? Because people, they are only the majority of villages are dependent on farming. So they are basic and the first occupation is farming only. But for urbanization people, we have different kind of service centers and multinationals we can work in there. Now the rural development. In 1961, 82% of Indian population resided in the villages. In 1971, the percentage of 80.1%. So far, the rural area has shouldered the responsibility of providing food, grains and other raw material to the urban area, supplying the labor, the industries, sectors of the society and taking care of the natural resources. There are three major challenges with reference to the rural development, namely bringing about the economic development, developing facilities to the meet social needs, and the finally bringing about the change of attitude in the matter concerning the society, culture and the ways of thinking is equally necessary to expedite irrigation projects and bring about the land reform. Now what about the rural development? In 1961, it was only 82% of Indian population which is resided in the village. After 1971, what happened? The percentage has went too far, that is 80.1. What is the main providing thing responsibility to these kind of urban areas? They are supplying labor and the food grains to urban people. Even they are the one who is protecting environment till now. They are providing food grains to us that to get the smooth life. If the rates are getting high, why this is high? Because the villagers are not getting proper resources. That's why they have to, they have to face the difficulties in the cultivations or, farming. And that's why the rates get high. And if a rate gets high, we need transportations to add taxes, different kind of taxes, even the government taxes. Then after that, when it comes to the customer, what happened? The prices get high. And who has to face this problem? The customers. The social needs and the facilities. It is necessary to give priority the facilities for public hygiene and health care. Even today, the culture population face program related to year-round positions, provision of drinking water, toilets, open drainage, narrow roads, inadequate electrifications, and the lack of facility for medical treatment. There is a lack of good quality in educational facility from primary level to the higher education centers for the recreation and the libraries. That is why this is necessary to give special attention to the rural area. The cultivate development schemes had an important place in the all first 5-year plans of the government of India. The state Maharashtra registered remarkable achievement under these schemes. For example, Zila Parishad was established in 1962, nutrition diet scheme was launched in 1970-71. The state also started rural water supply scheme for sinking wells and providing piped water by 1971-1677. Small dams had also been built. Now it's about the social needs and facilities. See, still in Bhiwandis also we have to face this water supply or drinking water, toilet and the open drainage, narrow roads and inadequate, you know, electrifications and even in the medical treatment. Why this has happened? Because of, you know, not paying attention to the social need and the public hygiene. So that's why, you know, government come with, you know, given the responsibility to Jilla Parishad and you know, Gram Panchayat to pay attention on such things. And after 1962, they get to know that we need to, you know, launch the nutrition diet, we have to launch the rural water supplies to public, even, you know, sinking well is not ready to, because they are open, so they cannot get the proper water. Because of that water pollution, polluted water, we get the face of different diseases. So they started, you know, providing pipe water to these people. We'll see till here. Next, we will continue in next lecture. Thank you. Assalamu alaikum, students. Welcome back to chapter number 9. That is Changing Life Cycle 1. We have seen till economic changes, rural development, social need and facilities, rural development and everything. Now, we'll see the rural electrifications. Electricity is essential for development of rural areas. Automatic pumps are needed to water the fields. Electricity is needed to preserve perishable foods items such as milk, eggs, fruits and vegetables. To run the fertilizer projects for fun and the TV and the lights for studying at night. During the first 5-year plan, electricity has been provided to 3,000 villages in India. By 1973, it reaches 138,646 villages. From 1963, it was decided supply more electricity for pumps and borewells. Rural Electrification Corporation was established in 1969. Rural Electrification Corporate Societies comes into being in the states of Andhra Pradesh, Gujarat, Karnataka, Maharashtra and Uttar Pradesh. See what happened now, the rural electrifications. That means electricity is more essential and important for every aspects of life. That means if you are in any area or in your any situation, electricity plays a very important role. Here, if you wanted to, you know, locate something or you want to do any transaction, your mobile phone is not charged, what you need is electricity. If you want to preserve any food that in the refrigerator, what is needed? Electricity. If you wanted to entertain yourself, what you need it? Electricity. By looking at, you know, by electricity you can switch on the TV. If you want to study, you need electricity to get study at night. If you want a fan or any of, you know, to make yourself cool, you need electricity to run the fan or AC. So this is the Rural Electrification Corporation had decided the number of the electricity provided to village are increased as well. Industrial development. A village industries planning committee was formed to help the development of industries in rural areas. By 1972, 106,000 persons got employment under this scheme. The government of Maharashtra has also started residential high schools known as Vidya Niketan in Satara, Aurangabad, Nasik and Chiklandra. Their purpose is to provide the best quality education, intelligent and meritorious village students living in an unfavorable condition. As per the recommendations of the Kotari Commission, Agriculture University were also started at Rahuri, Akola, Parbani and Dapoli in Maharashtra. In recognition of work done in the field of education, UNCSO
awarded its international prize for the spread of literacy to the Maharashtra in 1972. In this way, overcoming obstacle at the beginning of the post-independence period, India began to develop and make progress. In the next chapter, we shall learn more about employment developments in other fields. Now, what happened? The industrial development. Because of the industrial planning commissions, generated lots of employment to the villagers, as well as even the villagers, that they are also getting employment apart from farming. And Maharashtra, you know, they have provided a proper education in different areas of Maharashtra and other in Maharashtra. They got the recommendations from the Kothari Commission. Industrial universities are open, they get scholarships, and you know, they get the education. Village students are getting proper education, which before 1971 or 61 it was not there. In next chapter, we will see the more development of changing life cycle. We'll see till here. Next, we will continue in next lecture. Thank you.